When we read the Bible, we see many times that the Bible said they have to repent, and because they do something wrong, or they are baptized and they repent, and they're baptized to forgiveness of sins. Now, beloveds, when we look at what happens in the spirit world, my main objective for the next year, let me put it that way, is to get us all into a higher level of understanding. I want us to truly see that we're not of this world. Because when we can really see and we understand, because, beloveds, now many of us will say, yeah, but to see is to understand, and we make it very easy for ourselves. But, beloveds, it goes much higher than that, and it's much deeper than that, because God is reality, beloveds. And, you know, we're so used to just doing things what we're told, and we, with time, we forgot why we're here, what we're doing, how powerful we are. I want to ask you a question. If you see a lame man, and I go to that lame man, and I say, stand up and walk, thy sins are forgiven thee, and you have to see that, will you follow me? I'm asking you a question. Will you follow me?
Yes.
Yes.
You will follow me. If I go to a blind man and I make him see, will you follow me?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, so. Yes, we will.
Well, beloved, what I want you to see is how many lame people we give legs. How many of you didn't see what you see today? How many people have we, just through the videos, without even focusing on them, how many people have we given sight? I must send you some of these letters. Now, this is the world that I want us to live in. I want you to see with your spirit eye and live in the spirit world to see the miracles that we make people see, that we make the blind see, that we get the people onto the path to die on the cross, to pick up their cross and to die. And that's where I want you to be. Now, when you see that, beloved, when you're still looking for physical, I don't say you are. Please don't misunderstand me. Maybe that was a trick question. But I don't want us to wait for physical things to happen. We must be so spiritual that we can see. But this guy didn't understand these things before. I didn't understand these things before. And now I see. And that's where I want us to live. I want us to understand that we're building God a home, a temple, with all the great and soft-heartedness, meekness, kindness, love, because that is how God will live within us. That's the temple we have to build. That's the house we have to build. And that's the house we're building here with all these bricks for God to live within. And there where God is, there will be power. There will be love. There will be light. And that's where I want us to see. We must get away from wanting to see everything physically. Oh, God, you give us this, then I'll serve you. God does it. No, seek ye first my kingdom. And that is why I want us to start seeing spiritually. Because, beloveds, when we understand sin, like the baptism with John, they were baptized to the remission of sins and they repented. So, beloved, if we don't have the law, we don't have sin, isn't it? If we don't know the law, we don't have sin. We can't sin because we don't know the law. Because the law came by Moses. And then the people started understanding, the same as Adam. When he ate of the tree of knowledge, good and evil, then he knew he was naked. So when we receive the law, thou should not, thou must not, then we understand the law. And then when we understand the law, then we can sin. Because when we understand the law, we can't repent because we just learned what is right and what's wrong. So when we repent, beloveds, we must have sinned before, isn't it? It's the same with the valley of the dead bones. Go prophesy to the bones. Let them come back to life. There wouldn't have been bones if they weren't people before, if they weren't created into God's image before, because it wasn't dead and it isn't dead bones, physical dead bones. It's the order and the structure of the mind. And that's why they died. So that's why they repented, because we sinned and now we're coming back to the truth. But it's not always our fault, beloveds. Because we never understood, we never really were given the eye to see and the wisdom to know and understand. Now I want to take us a step closer, and we've spoken about this before. How do we sin? How do we bring bad things upon ourselves? Because you have to remember, beloved, Jesus said, drink, this is my blood, for the remission of sins for many. Not for everybody. People think, oh no, Jesus died for the whole world. No. I died for you. You will die for your brothers and sisters. You will die for those who will come to you. You have to die. Then God will bring those to you that you have to set free. So that is why we will die. You will die for many. Because he says, and when Jesus took up the book, he knew that he had to die, but his death will mean life for many. That's you, beloveds. You have to die. You have to conquer the mind. We have to understand that the Bible isn't, please, beloveds, I want us to, I'm telling you all these things because I don't want you to read the Bible as a storybook or something to judge others with or some. You must sit and meditate and think, what does this mean? How can I live this? How can I conquer this? How can I inherit eternal life? That's why you're here. You want to enter God's kingdom. You want to enter the levels of truth. Because God is truth. Jesus is truth. The Holy Spirit is truth. This is not truth. This is an illusion. And you want to ascend into we will be forever. And you must know how to ascend. Now, beloveds, sin is that which will make us lose sight. It will make us ill. Because, beloved, the man next to the bath of Bethesda, Jesus said to him, go, thy sins are forgiven thee. And he was healed. You know, I said that to my brother once. He's a priest. And I spoke to him about karma. I was still busy with St. Mutt and Eastern religions. One of his members were ill. And I said, it's his karma. It's his sin. And he said, no, that's a lot of rubbish. And I said, the man was next to the bath of Bethesda. And Jesus said, go, thy sins are forgiven thee. And he was healed. So what made him ill? His sins. Now we can say yes, but that's spiritual. Yes, beloved. God says, thou shalt not kill. Will it be a sin when I kill somebody? When I remove the soul from the physical body? Yes, it will be. When I harm people, will it be a sin? Yes, it will. So we have the physical and we have the spiritual. And that's why God is teaching us these things, so we know how not to sin. Because what stands between you and God is darkness. What stands between you and God, those who are pure of heart will see God. We will enter the kingdom of God when we become pure of heart. Why? When we become God-friendly. And when we do sin, beloved, we're sowing evil on the earth all the time. What is going to grow? What is this Garden of Eden going to look like? There won't be fruit. There won't be nothing. So I'm walking quite a long way with us all today, beloved. But I'll bring it all together. I want us to understand that you must see when we heal somebody that's blind. Don't be blind ourselves to just listen to people and you must do this and you must do that and this one. Oh, that's so beautiful. Is it beautiful? Can you really see it? Can you see that person? Can see, he's understanding what's happening to him. Now, when I read the Bible, I can honestly see how Jesus heals people. He makes them understand. Give me some of your water. Take his earth to make him see. Put the spit and make him see. I want you to know when you read the Bible and you meditate about it, you must say, but then I can do it as well. Because that's what God is teaching me. The formula of how to heal, how to make the blind see, what makes me blind, what makes me crippled, excuses makes me crippled. Whatever I sow, I reap. So that's why, beloved, God made, I've said this before and I've stated in the books as well. What you sow, you reap in spirit. If I say bad things, beloved, it's going to come back to me. It happens in the physical side as well. Because when you jump out of a four-story building, you're going to either break your legs or you're going to die. So when you hit the ground after 4 or 5 seconds, everything's broken. It took you 5 seconds to hit the ground. How long will it take you to heal? And that's why God says he blesses everything in abundance. So if you sow one piece of corn or one pip, how much do you harvest? How much do you reap? Plenty. So, beloved, that's why I say, is it true? Is it necessary? Is it kind? If it's not all three, beloved, don't say it. Sometimes we have to sort something out, or we have to be, it sounds mean to somebody to help them. And many of you will get very angry with me at times. We have to understand how these things work, beloveds. And so we don't have to do it. So we don't have to repent again and again and again. And that's why God says, when you remit them their sins will be remitted. But when you keep it, it will be kept. How does that happen, beloved? So if you have sins, I say, your sins are remitted, forgiven you, and now your sins are forgiven you. And now I'm angry with you like they always are, and say, no, your sins are kept. Let's see what happens to you. Beloved, believe me, that's not God. When you are in the hollow of God's hand, he will always, always help you. But you have to have a mouthpiece because God is the Word. Now you need a mouthpiece to teach you how your sins can be remitted. In other words, when I teach you, then you know how to not commit a sin again. Because now you know better. You've seen the light. And then you won't do it again. Because so many people get hurt, beloved, and they don't know why these things happen. And once you're in that rut, it's just the one thing, and then the next, and then the next, and then the next. Why? Because we're not guided. We can't lay our dreams. We don't have visions anymore. And when those dreams come, and that's what I pray for us as well, beloved. When we dream, God will warn us. Because he says, I will do nothing and nothing will happen to you if I didn't warn you. Nothing. And that's the Father we serve, beloved. We are his son. And I want those things to become a reality again. I want life to be within us. And God is life. God is light. God is the truth. And that's why I'm starting for us to understand. I want us to understand these things really, really well. We must know what we're saying. We must see. When you're taking earth from somebody, from his mind, or you say, drink my water, or give me some of your water to drink, you must see it. You must know what you're busy doing. You must know that God is now working through you. You must live in those realms. You must get away from this and say, oh, give me some of your water, and I will bless you, and I don't. Be a servant. Be a medium for God. Let God work through us, and let us live in those heavens, beloveds. Let us see what we're busy with. Let us understand, because, beloved, I promise you, at this level, God is a word. But at the next level, there's no words. It becomes a reality. This now is for you a reality, because that's all you know. The mind is all you know. We don't know God. We think we know, beloveds. And even when you know in the next heaven, you still don't know. So all I want you to really, really, really understand, beloveds, if you want to enter the kingdom of God and become part of it, everything you learn, don't take it to heart, to the mind, and think, now I know. Beloved, every time you see the light, go on your knees and say, that shows you how little I know. And God, that light that you have given me, let that grow. And then the more light you receive, beloved, become humbler to see what I know even less. The more the power of God is revealed to me, the more I understand how little I know. And that is the way of becoming humble and building God a home within you. That, beloved, is the way to ascend, to do descend first and just view this powerful God that we're serving, that we can't even fathom. When you wake up in the morning, beloved, and you see the sun come up, appreciate it. When you see the birds, appreciate it, because it's all our Father. And although it's outside of us, just admire his beauty. Because we know nothing, beloveds. And I want that state of mind that we want power and we want to be better than others and we want to know better than others. I want us to get that out of us. I don't say you do. I love you all to bits. Please, beloved, don't misunderstand me. But that's what's happening in dogmas. When I get a position, I'm now more than you, and now you listen to me. That is such a shame. Because I never became an instrument in the hand of the Father. You become an instrument, beloved, to die. You become an instrument to become less. You become an instrument for God to grow within you. And that is why it's so important. Before I want to become something, show me, Father, how to become nothing. And it starts off by being a child. To be a child. And what makes a child special, beloved? He's dependent. A child is dependent on his food, on his clothes, on a nice warm bed to live in. Everything is dependent on the father and the mother. And that is where we begin. We begin not to ascend, but to descend. Because he that descended is the same as he who ascended above all heavens, beloved. Ephesians 4, says Paul. And that is where we begin. Let us become nothing for God, not even a child anymore, beloved. It will always start off with a child. But as long as there's a child, they're still kicking and screaming and moaning, because a child can be very, very demanding. For as long as there's a child, there's still space for God to, you know, we remove the child. Let only God remain. Let only spirit remain. And that is why I want us to understand, when you look with the eye of God. Look at what we're accomplishing. Look at how the people are starting to see. Don't look at numbers. Look at the miracles. Look at what we're accomplishing. And then we can ascend into these higher levels of God consciousness and understanding and love and light, beloveds. And when we're there, just say, Father, thank you. Just take over everything, please. Just take over everything. I messed up everything my entire life. And I don't want to mess up more things. But if I do, then please be part of it, because then I know you want to teach me something. And that's who we are, beloveds. We're the Son. And the Father is not dependent on the Son. The Son is dependent on the Father. We are just an instrument, God in flesh, God with us. So let God be the one that speaks through us. Let God be the one that teaches us. By remitting sins, beloved, is getting rid of darkness. By remitting sins is for the light to shine within us. And that is love. And that is why, beloved, if you don't learn this true light and this true wisdom, you can never have love. You can say love like everybody out there. Oh, we love you all and we love you. They can't love you, even if they want to, because they've never seen the Father. That is love. Because the love you have for somebody, beloved, is that soul. And when you connect with the soul, you connect with everything. And then you will know how to peel it off, that darkness, the mind. For that, get rid of the sin. So to repent, beloved, again, that sin is not to say, God, forgive me, or your sins are forgiven you. Show me how to become holy. Show me how to become separated. Our Father, like Brother Reuben said the other day, our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Hallowed is to be holy, is to be separated. And you, beloved, take it or leave it, are becoming very, very separated. And the more you learn, the more you'll see. Go talk to other people what you learn, yeah? See how separated you've become. Try and explain it to somebody. That's very difficult. Yes? Because, beloved, you're ascending. You're becoming more enlightened all the time. But it will all come together, beloveds. But what my prayer tonight is to conquer the sin, beloved, is to conquer mind by becoming humble, by becoming nothing. When I am nothing, when there's no more darkness, there'll be light. It doesn't happen overnight, beloveds. It takes time and it takes hard work and it takes crucifixion and it takes willingness to learn. Remember that. We have to be willing to learn. We have to be willing to bow. And that is to bow before our Father. Respect, love, honor. Because we cannot fathom, beloved, our Father. As I said, just look at the sun. Look at the universe. Look at a leaf. Look at a dog. Look how much passion that animal has. A cat. All these people, the love we have for each other. That's Father, beloved. So let us go back and see before we go forward to fight and pick up stones. They will stone you, but you don't have flesh, so you can't hurt. Don't worry about it. But you become nothing. And everything you learn, Father, I always thought I knew something. But the more I learn, the more I see how little I know. And that's why we can't demand, beloved, when Moses went to the rock, he hit the rock. With what? With a staff. What's the staff? The word. We demand from God, I want water. You teach me. We can't do that. That's the Old Testament. We don't demand nothing anymore. Not when you become the son. Then you're the one they will demand from. Because you will be rejected with a father, with all your brothers and sisters. So my prayer to tonight, beloved, is let us become humble. Let us become nothing. And let us make God everything in our lives. To learn is to see how little I know. And to ascend is not, beloveds, to ascend is to descend. Oh, and to do this is to do that. And your sins are forgiven you and this. No. Make it a reality. Think. Meditate. Pray. Don't pray for your food and say, oh, Lord, thank you for the food. And da, 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 da. Pray. Say, Lord, thank you for the health I have to have food to eat. Thank you, beloveds, for everything I have. Father, thank you for the health I have to have a job or to have an income and for everything you're giving me. Pray with sincerity every time you pray, beloved. And thank Father. And that Father, who's way above our human comprehension, he will uplift you. And I said again, it starts with a word, but that's only the beginning. It becomes much bigger because you're not always in this flesh, are you? And even when you ascend, you're not in the flesh anymore, is it? Because the flesh has to return to the earth. And then what remains? God, beloveds, spirit, light, love, truth, power. And that's who we are. That's where we're headed. And that's why I say, don't judge others, beloved. Because they don't deserve it. They don't have what you have. They don't have what we have. They don't have God. They don't have this truth. They don't have the Spirit. Because the Holy Spirit, he said, the world cannot receive it because they seeth it not. They can't understand this. It's crazy to them. But unto you it is given to understand the mysteries of the kingdom of my Father. The main thing, beloveds, is don't sow evil. Be circumcised. Don't talk evil. Don't listen to evil things. Don't think evil things. It's difficult. But when you get those thoughts, think about God. Think about something nice. Think of a tree. Think of everything else. When you talk, let that little voice tell you, don't say that before you say it. Don't say it. Don't say it. Because you're going to dirty your house. Don't say it. And then we can start building within our hearts We can start healing the blind. We can start making the lame walk. And not the lame walk to go walk physically, to walk towards the cross, to walk towards God, the path, Christ. I am the way, the truth, and the life. Nobody comes to Father but by me, and you'll walk with your cross. Love God above all and thy neighbor as thyself. And that's where we're headed, beloveds. Let us not sin, but let us understand how much power we have. We really can turn water into wine. We can take any evangelistic teaching and turn it into wine. We can make blind people see. We can make the lame walk. We can make anything happen. So let this happen in our physical worlds as well. Let us, I don't say that we're going to go and walk out there and try and heal everybody. Seek ye the kingdom of God first. The rest will happen the way God wants it. Let him guide us with the dreams, with the prophecies, with the visions. And this is a prophecy, beloved. When you speak to me, I listen to the prophet. When you explain something to me, I listen to the prophet. And that's what we have to listen to understand our path, to get to Father, and let us see how little we know.